Architecture is not only about function. It can also be a space for stories that influence us and promote a new sense of understanding to the buildings. While buildings can be magnificent storytellers, most of them are instead rooted in economics and the desire to build quickly and cheaply. In this video, we will be showing you the four pillars of storytelling in architecture as described in a research paper by Claire Nicole Wallace at the University of Tennessee in Knoxville. The four pillars of storytelling are framing, supporting, locating, and forming. Before we start, make sure that you are subscribed to our channel. And now, let us investigate. Framing. Modern architecture is both a need and an economic tool. Architects and their respective clients aim to reach efficient spaces with the least number of resources and highest outcome. Framing architecture, from this perspective, produces one-layered architecture. However, architecture with meaning should be formed with multi-layering in mind. To have these levels of layering, an architect needs to consider not only the style or the budget, but also the cultural history, materials, technology, evolution, and of course the inhabitants, their needs, their wants, and emotions. This can be achieved with a proper spatial language. Framing can be seen as interweaving the old and the new, experimentation with materials and inviting nature, and using architecture as a discovery tool, and so on. Supporting. Ideas are like products. Both are human creations. Good architecture should be a support to the old and the new ideas of the site or the existing architecture that lies on that site. A building site is a crucial element in the successful telling of a story. It dictates the types of activities that will aid in the telling of the story of the site. Thus, producing good architecture is related to the production of ideas that are well preserved and felt inside a given site. Music, for example, is something magical where it is produced in a moment and then felt forever. Good architecture should be able to capture that feeling and preserve it for anyone going into that space to feel the music, even if it was not playing. Locating. Carol J. Burns once said, "Every site is a unique intersection of land, climate, production, and circulation. Each area has a story to tell. Thus, it is important to know where you will locate the project you have in mind." In fact, one location can have multiple relationships with different areas. For example, East Tennessee is an area rich in a variety of scenery. One may venture short distances and see rolling and covered hills, rocky cliffs jutting up from the glistening Tennessee River, the ever-active campus at the University of Tennessee, and the historical blocks of downtown Knoxville. College campus, the river, and downtown Knoxville also have an intense relationship with South Knoxville, making it a very inspiring area of study. After all, the natural topography of each site plays a huge role. Forming. The author discussed two ways to translate form and stories in architecture: spatial language and multi-layering spaces. Good architecture tells the story through the use of forms in a certain spatial language interacting with a given site. A spatial language should reverse the past, fit the present, and be adaptable to the future. The story of the site is always evolving, always growing, and always changing. Likewise, the spaces that are created need to be able to grow and change to relate to the conditions of the area. Additionally, form is the creation of layered spaces and planes, and thus the creation of a layered story. In this way, users and visitors would catch glimpses of each other's activities and functions relative to the project aim. Architecture could also act as a frame for viewing existing elements of the site. then one will be aware of the space inhabited as well as how the space interacts with others and thus the layers of the story. Architecture and storytelling are inseparable. Now that we have reached the end of this video, I want you to tell me in the comments your favorite story an architectural project can tell you. Make sure you are subscribed to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for making it to the end of this video. Have a happy holiday, and we will see you in the next one.